Sergey.
The face you see there is a Paul Hilgardner, top competitor in the unusual sport of luge. Now, earlier, Jim McKay had a look at the life and times of Paul Hilgardner.
Four-year-old Alexander probably doesn't know that his father is one of the best lugers in the world. He does know, though, that his dad is a policeman, one of the carabinieri, here at their impressive headquarters in Val Gardena, Italy. Actually, his father won a doubles gold medal in Sapporo in 1972. He also won a singles world championship in 1978. And in Lake Placid, he added another silver medal to his collection. He trained with his teammate Ernst Hasfinger, who was also a member of the Carabinieri. Not bad duty, really. Paul, an expert in the preparation of the sled, places great emphasis on the combination of technique and proper equipment.
With us in luge sport, technique plays a very large role. And in fact, what provides the success is the equipment, the sleds. To a degree, they are put together by both the trainer and the athletes themselves.
Hunting is another great passion in Paul Hilgardner's life. Perhaps it's the long drive up into the magnificent Alps that surround his home. Maybe it's a chance simply to think about a new sled design or a training technique for the upcoming season. But in the midst of this kind of beauty, it's enough to imagine that maybe the scenery is its own reward. And for a 31-year-old luger near the end of a highly successful career, this is an important chance to consider both the present and the future.
A few moments ago, a sudden gust of wind blew across the track, drifting tons of snow onto the track. Now, this man, Paul Hilgardner, now in second, faces a difficult situation because he doesn't know what is ahead down the run. Paul Hilgardner, 31, a true winter athlete, Jeff, a man with a good metabolism for cold weather.
Sam, that's true. He's been at the top of this sport for almost 12 years, and he continues to dominate. Also, one of the nicest guys on the circuit. I remember my first international race. In the middle of the race, he took time to help me out with an adjustment on my sled. Just an all-around great, great guy.
All right, he's approaching that turn five. Watch for the split on the upper part. Yes,
fast.
He's working a good run. Paul Hilgardner now moving very fast down the course.
He's flying, Sam. He's absolutely flying. He's really got this run wired. I think this is going to be a smoker for him.
All right, his form looks absolutely perfect. His legs dead parallel and his toes pointed forward. Paul Hilgardner now working through the labyrinth.
Beautiful.
And just one turn ahead of him now, Jeff.
Fantastic labyrinth, fantastic run. Oh,
all
there you
right.
go, there you
look
go.
At that, Paul Hilgardner, he has set a new track record on that run, and that moves him into first place. Paul Hilgardner from northern Italy, do you see him wave
there? Knows it, Sam,
just,
he knows it.
He's just moved into first place with a record run. Well, what an achievement, Jeff. That is fantastic. He needed it at this point to upset his opponents, and he did it. Could very well be the most important run of the day. East Germany's Torsten Görlitzer, study his face, relatively unknown before these Olympics. He emerged in the lead after yesterday's run, and now with a spotlight on him for the first time in his career, he faces the pressure of having to match that brand new track record that Paul Hilgardner just set. Iron control over your mind now and emotions, Jeff. That's what he's got to have. He knows he's got to come up with something brilliant.
It's going to be interesting to see, Sam, if he can handle it. As you mentioned, he has limited experience, only 3 or 4 international races. Coaches decided to bring him here. He showed promise in training. He's young, though. It'll be interesting
to see. Watch the split. No, Jeff. Disappointing start off the top. Comment on his form now.
Not very good, Sam. He's ragged all the way down. A real surprise. He smoked the first 2 runs, but he's banging walls, dragging feet. It looks like the pressure might have gotten to him. We'll see.
Torsten Görlitzer, he may be blowing it. He looked a little high there. Now he's coming into the labyrinth. Torsten Görlitzer with one turn ahead of him. You see what he's got to do to take the lead? No! Not only does he not take the lead, he's blown it. He's dropped back to fourth. Torsten Görlitzer.
A ragged run all the way down. Obviously, Paul Hilgardner put the heat on with the track record, and he didn't make it.
That is the face of Michael Walters in the men's start house now from East Germany. His medal hopes have been brightening steadily, Jeff. Fourth at the end of the first run, third at the end of the second run. Now he's seen the collapse of his teammate, Thorsten Gerlitzer. He's got a good shot at the bronze at the least.
Well, Sam, if he uncorks one here, he could even move into second place and lock up a position or a good shot at a silver medal tomorrow. And wouldn't he love to beat Sergey Danil in the Russian for that?
Right, that's the time he's got to beat, Danilin's time. There is, no love lost between the East Germans and the men from the Soviet Union. He loses yet.
No, they have a real rivalry. They really like beating each other, Sam.
All right, his upper split time is excellent. He's only about a tenth off. He's in good shape.
Very nice run developing here for him. Very smooth, very fast.
Walters now working the lower part of the track. He's a little rough there. Into the labyrinth. This is the last turn now. Michael Walters. And
he does it.
That is a fantastic run for him. He has nailed down second place, Michael Walters. All right. The end of the third run in the men's luge competition. A day of high drama. The Italian veteran, Paul Hilgartner, has moved into the lead following a brilliant run, a track record. In second, Michael Walter, who you just saw, of East Germany. Steady, consistent, but menaced now by Sergey Danilin of the Soviet Union. Danilin, eighth after the first run, fourth after the second, is now just 34 one-thousandths of a second behind Walter. The big story, the collapse under pressure of the East German rookie Thorsten Gerlitzer. Leader coming into the competition today, he has fallen to fifth. American Frank Maisley is 16th. Three runs have been completed. One run left to go.
Okay, that was the luge on Mount Trebevich. You know, it's kind of difficult to get a phone call to the States from here in Sarajevo, and understandably so, with all the thousands of people.